I'm joined by Digvijaya Singh, former two-time Chief Minister of Madhya Pradesh. Appreciate your joining us, Mr. Digvijaya Singh. The big question to you, how do you respond to those who say that the rebellion of Jyotiraditya Scindia was caused by your Digvijaya Singh's attitude towards him, that you were blocking his rise in the Congress party?
Well, let me put it on record. It was I and Mr. Arjun Singh ji, under the direction of Sanjay Gandhi ji, in 1979, brought Madhya Rao ji Scindia into Congress party. And we worked together until his sad accident, sad demise, which is very unfortunate. And there was no problem in working with Mr. Madhya Rao Scindia. In those years. Later also, when Jyotiraditya, he's almost like my son, he worked with me and he never complained about any misbehavior from my side on any issue, whether we were in government or out of government. So therefore, there was no question of my being against him.
The charge being made by Scindia supporters, Mr. Digvijaya Singh, is that you and Kamal Nath got together and were not giving him any political space, not giving Jyotiraditya Scindia any political space. You were not willing to make him Madhya Pradesh Congress chief. Even the Rajya Sabha seat that comes up in a few days was not certain. How true is that? That you were even going to the extent of denying him even a Rajya Sabha seat?
No question. In fact, I had told Congress President and my General Secretary Mr. Bavaria that I will be very happy if he is made the PCC President. I have no objections. I have no problems. You can check up with Mr. Jyotiraditya Scindia also. He was offered PCC presidentship way back in 2013, after the 2013 parliament assembly election which we lost. And I'm told he denied. We had no problem him becoming a deputy chief minister also, which also he denied. He wanted one of his nominees to be made a deputy chief minister. As far as the Rajya Sabha is concerned, there was no problem. We have the numbers. We could have easily got him the minimum votes required was 58. And we were 122, so there was no problem at all.
You know, are you therefore telling me today that all these charges that Jyotiraditya Scindia and his supporters are making, that out of the two Rajya Sabha seats, one was going to go to you, second was going to go to a Kamal Nath supporter, Scindia would be kept out, that there was a conscious attempt being made not to give him any position of authority? You're denying all that? You're saying this is all being made up by Scindia and his supporters?
No, totally I denied. Because who was opposing? No one was opposing him. What made him think that anyone was opposing him? No one was opposing him.
You know, the reason I'm saying this is today in his press conference, he seemed to indicate, or his supporters certainly are saying, that Digvijaya Singh was running this government as a backroom operator. Kamal Nath was controlling the administration. And the two of you were running this government the way exactly you wanted. And while leaving the party, he seems to mention that it is time for me to move on because I cannot serve the people of Madhya Pradesh and the country when someone else is taking all the decisions. That's the insinuation, that the two of you, Kamal Nath and Digvijaya Singh, were running the government in Madhya Pradesh.
Let me put it on record, Rajdeep. First of all, there were six ministers who have gone with him. They had independent portfolios and they never complained of any interference from either Digvijaya Singh or Mr. Kamal Nath. I don't know about Mr. US Chief Minister, but I never interfered in their working. And as far as the issue of the officers, its postings, etc. is concerned, let me also tell you, Rajdeep, I and Mr. Jyotiraditya Scindia ji, and before him, his father, Madhya Rao ji Scindia, we share the home district of Guna. This is where I was elected, and this was a home district. But even as a chief minister, I used to post officers of the choice of Mr. Madhya Rao Scindia. And in this case also, when Congress government came, the collector and the SP and the officers posted in Guna were of the choice of Jyotiraditya Singh. I never complained, I never proposed. Absolutely.
The charge that is being made is that you and Kamal Nath are today running a transfer posting parallel industry in Madhya Pradesh. People are appointed on whims and fancies of the two of you, and therefore, according to Jyotiraditya Singh, the real issues, farmer loans, issues of the small industry, all of these were being kept on the side. Everything was on how to make money through this parallel industry of transfers and postings.
I will request Mr. Kamal Nath to give the list of transfers and postings which have been done of his choice. Okay, that would prove the point.
You know, my...
We've got all the letters.
My question to you, sir, is why should then a young leader at the age of 49, whose father was part of your generation, who had a rich legacy in the Congress, suddenly leave? If everything was so hunky-dory as you are making it out to be, why should Jyotiraditya Singh leave the Congress and join the BJP?
It surprised me also. But then when I sort of go back to this, he made a statement against the Congress line in the matter of revoking of the Article 370 in Kashmir. He also supported the BJP stand on NPR-NRC. Mm-hmm. Also, we have come to know that he has been in touch with Mr. Amit Shah and Modi and the BJP leaders after he lost the election, unfortunately. You see, we had such fine, I would say, relationship that he used to come to my house. He would not allow me to go to his house to meet him. And we used to discuss for hours together political situation and other matters. We had family relationship, and today also we have our family relationship. There's no problem at all.
Sir, but
this came up as a surprise to me.
Sir, you're saying it came as a surprise to you. That's interesting to hear that. But something surely then must have happened for Jyotiraditya Singh to take such a big step. And not just him, sir. 22 MLAs, including some who are very close to you, have walked out of the Congress at a moment like this. Surely there is some reason, something has gone wrong in the way the Congress was running the state, that 22 MLA should suddenly leave. Why has it happened?
Rajdeep, there's some what I have gathered in the last few days is that after he lost the election, he had approached through some of his relations who are in BJP to meet Mr. Modi and Mr. Amit Shah. And they had some discussion of some kind of an understanding with the BJP. When it was this subject was broached with the state leadership of the BJP, they said no, we will not accept him. And if you want the government to be changed, or you want the Congress government to be toppled, we will do it. We will get the Congress MLAs to resign, and we will topple the government. So the operation, I would say, Operation Moneybag started after that. But unfortunately, their Operation Moneybag was punctured by our Congress people, and it failed. So this Amit Shah then fell to the plan B, that, okay, you people can't do it. You are opposing Jyotiraditya Singh. So it's better we takes Jyotiraditya Singh.
No, you are claiming today on my show that this operation, therefore, what you're calling Operation Money Bags of the BJP and Amit Shah, since you've used his name, has been brewing for several months. Do you have any proof at all that the 35 crores that you have claimed on Twitter is the price per MLA have actually exchanged hands? Do you have any proof, or are you just making wild charges, sir?
You see, this has been the phone calls made to the MLAs who have recorded their talk and have made it public also. If you want to see it, you can see it.
You know, I must ask you this. You are saying you were caught by surprise. How are two seasoned politicians like Kamal Nath and Digvijaya Singh caught unawares of the Scindia resignation and 22 MLAs deciding to switch sides that has pushed your government to the brink? What does it say about your system of managing a crisis of intelligence gathering?
Because we believed in Mr. Jyotiraditya Singh. We had faith in Mr. Jyotiraditya Singh. That's why.
You're saying you had faith in Jyotiraditya Singh. That's why you were caught by surprise. Tell me, sir, the big question. Do you think now that this government of Kamal Nath can survive the Congress government, do you concede it is now extremely difficult for the government to survive, given the fact that none of these 22 MLAs seem at the moment ready to return?
The whole thing depends on the 22 Congress MLAs which the BJP has taken in chartered flights engaged by the BJP from Delhi to Bangalore. Now they have sent the signed resignation letters through a BJP MLA and ex-minister Bhupen Singh. Now they say it's an internal matter of the Congress party. If it's an internal matter of the Congress party, why the resignation letters of the Congress MLAs being brought by a BJP MLA and ex-minister Bhupen Singh and submitted to the speaker? It's totally, I would say, engineered and executed by the BJP leadership.
So the
in a stage where the whole country is reeling under economic crisis, when the whole country is going through the coronavirus, Mr. Amit Shah doesn't have time for this. He has time for toppling governments.
The question is, will your government be toppled? Will your government survive or not, Digvijaya Singh?
Well, let us see. We are hopeful. We are confident.
You know, Digvijaya Singh ji, there are those also who are questioning the Gandhi family leadership. According to them, according to Jyotiraditya Singh's supporters, the Gandhi leadership were not even taking his calls at state level. As I said earlier, you are marginalizing him. He feels, therefore, that ambitions are being, his supporters feel ambitions of young generation next leaders are being stalled. Therefore, he can do Jan Seva only in the BJP. How do you respond?
I am very sorry to hear this argument and this complaint by Mr. Jyotiraditya Singh against the Gandhi family. Gandhi family has been extremely, I would say, close to Madhurao Scindia and to Mr. Jyotiraditya Singh later on. And Mr. Rahul Gandhi has given a statement. He was one politician who could walk into his house anytime. So where is the miscommunication, lack of communication between the two? And Mrs. Sonia Gandhi has been extremely soft and has given ample opportunities to Mr. Jyotiraditya Singh.
So you don't agree with this theory that the Congress is imploding, there is the old guard versus the generation next, that people like you and Kamal Nath are simply unwilling to give any space to the younger leaders, and that is the crux of the problem in the Congress today.
How dare you call me old, Rajdeep? I'm a young man.
You are a young man. Okay, you are a young man. I know that 73, I guess, is a young age for you, Mr. Digvijaya Singh. I want to ask you one final question. Kya aap floor, this is for Aaj Tak in particular. Kya aap floor test lenge? Because there is a question ki aap, that Kamal Nath ji could well resign in the next 48 hours. Aap floor test pe apni bahumat sidh kar payenge ya nahi? Will you go for a floor test ya usse pehle hi Kamal Nath istifa denge?
Puri taiyari hamari hai, floor test hum log karayenge. Jin logon ne istife diye hain unka speaker sahab ke samne unka one to one jaake wo apne aap keh denge, uske baad hum log floor test kara lenge.
Okay, Digvijaya Singh, you're ready for a floor test. You're saying, abhi bhi main jawan hu. You're saying, how dare you call me old? And Jyotiraditya Singh was like a son to you who's betrayed you. Thank you very much for joining me. Jyotiraditya Singh there, Digvijaya Singh there talking on Jyotiraditya Singh.
Hi everyone, Preeti Chaudhary here. Hope you like this video. For latest news and analysis, like and subscribe to the India Today YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated. Thank you for watching.